Well, she runs a government that was born out of a hung parliament, which makes it fragile at best. And as we've already mentioned, opinion polls, carbon tax and the budget, let alone asylum seekers and the NBN, probably all feel like dirty words to the Prime Minister right now. And all that with Kevin Rudd seemingly circling like a vulture. Well, to say the least, Julia Gillard's life is pretty interesting. Nerve-wracking, I imagine, but interesting. And the PM has been good enough to join us live from Adelaide, where she's hosting a community cabinet meeting. Prime Minister, good to see you again.
Good evening, George.
Not a very pleasant way to start an interview, but if there was an election held this weekend, you'd get battered.
Well, George, there will be an election in 2013. This Parliament will go full term and we will keep working through to do the big things we need to do for our nation's future, to keep our economy strong and to spread better opportunities to Australians. That's what the budget was all about, and that's in fact what carbon pricing is about, doing what we need to do by our environment, but also getting the clean energy jobs of the future.
Let me give you a little, if you like, political shopping list that I jotted down of the things that you do have to deal with if, as you say, the Parliament will run its full term and I imagine you would think that you're going to win. You've got a lot of work ahead of you. A lukewarm reaction to last week's budget. Very mixed response, you have to say, to the NBN startup. The country's still savagely divided. Some people even openly opposed or confused about the whole idea of climate change and a carbon tax. Not to mention the asylum seekers. Oops, what's been going on there? And as I said, the poll's not looking at all good for you. Now, that is a high climb for you to make. That's a long road ahead. And where are you going to start? Which one of those things that are keeping your government in the situation they're in now?
Well, we've got a lot of hard work to do, George, I understand that, but the budget we delivered last week is the budget that's right for our economy. It'll bring the budget to surplus in 2012-13 as promised and create 500,000 more jobs whilst we spread opportunity around the country. On asylum seekers, well, we are working to finalise our agreement with Malaysia. We want to take out of people smugglers' hands the very product that they sell. On carbon pricing, I'm just saying to Australians, judge in the middle of the year when you've got all of the details about the assistance your household is going to get. And on the NBN, George, I was in Armidale yesterday with an incredibly enthusiastic community wanting the NBN switched on, the first switch on in mainland Australia. And here I am Adelaide today, and I've met with local council representatives that are desperately awaiting the NBN.
Let me ask you this then. The country's in a bit of a parlous state, if you ask me right now, because most people think we've got a government that can't govern and an opposition that does nothing but oppose. That's a pretty sorry state for a country to be in, democratically speaking.
Oh, George, I don't agree with your characterisations. The government is getting on with the job.
So why are the polls so bad? Sorry to interrupt you, but if that's the case, if the government's getting on with the job, why have so few people impressed by the way you're getting on with the job?
Well, George, I don't govern with an eye on the polls. I govern with my eyes on the future of this country, on what's going to keep our economy strong and what's going to bring to Australians the benefits of better opportunities. A better opportunity for a job, a better opportunity for a training place, a better school for their child, a fair go at getting an apprenticeship, a decent health system that they can turn to in times of need. That's what's driving me. We'll have the election in 2013 and people will have their say in 2013. In the meantime, yes, we've got a lot of hard work to deliver on the big picture issues that challenge our nation. The one thing I'd agree with you about is the opposition's got really no idea or no plans, except Tony Abbott has now had Malcolm Turnbull bell the cat for him. Tony Abbott's got a climate change plan that will bust the budget and which won't work. That's what Malcolm Turnbull's saying.
You're the one still to convince people that you can do the job. Look, we have to leave you there, unfortunately, but we'll talk to you again and enjoy Adelaide.
George, I'm an optimist, I'm getting on with the job and I'm really looking forward to community cabinet here in Adelaide.
Thanks for talking to us. Good to see you again.
Thank you.